dear students, today we are going to start with the chapter The Earth in the Solar System. This is the first chapter of geography. So, what does the word solar mean first? Solar means that is something that is related to the sun, like solar energy. The energy that we get from the sun, that is known as solar energy. Now comes the solar system. What is solar system? Solar system. Sun, moon, all the planets, satellites and celestial bodies, they form the solar system. All these things together form the solar system. Now what do you know about the celestial bodies? What are celestial bodies? Celestial bodies are the objects like sun, moon and other shining objects in the night sky are known as celestial bodies. Now, some celestial bodies, they are very bright, they are hot balls of gases. They have their own heat and light. Do you know what I am talking about? I am talking about the stars. Stars are the celestial bodies that have their own heat and light. Our sun is also a star. With countless twinkling stars in the sky, sun is like one of them. But other stars, they appear very small to us. Do you know why? Why the stars appear so small to us? Because they are very far from us. Stars, they are very far from us. That's why they look very small, very tiny in their size. Let me give you an example here. Take the example of an aeroplane. An aeroplane is so big. But when we see it flying in the sky, it looks very small to us. So, as compared to the original size of the aeroplane, same as with the stars. Because they are very far from us, that's why they look very small to us. Next comes the constellation. Constellation. What is constellation? Constellation is the pattern. Stars, they form patterns in the night sky. So, the constellations are the patterns that are formed by the stars in the sky. One of the major, there are many constellations in the night sky. One easily seen constellation in the night sky is the Saptarishi. 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 Sapt means seven. Rishi means sages. So, it is a group of seven stars. That's why it is known as Saptarishi. Have you ever seen Saptarishi in the night sky? If you have not seen, do it today. Go at the terrace with the elder family members and watch it in the night sky. It looks like this. Here it is. I'm going to draw it. It is a group of seven stars.
Constellation
nice pie. So do it today. Watch it with the help of your family members. Then let's start with our solar system, that is sun. Sun is in the center of the solar system. It is in the center of the solar system, and it is made up of mainly two gases, that is hydrogen and helium. Sun is made up of two gases, that is hydrogen and helium, hot ball of gases. Then sun has the gravitational pull also. So there is gravitational pull, it binds the solar system, it binds all the planets with it. Do you know how far is the sun? I have told you that sun is also a star, but we cannot see. Why can you, do you know why we cannot see the stars during the daytime? Because the bright light of the sun does not allow us to see the stars at night. Because the light of the sun is very bright and we cannot see the stars at night. Then comes the distance of the sun. Our sun is 150 million kilometer away from the earth. Sun is 150 kilometer away from the earth, and the light which we get from the sun, that takes 8 minutes and 20 seconds to reach the earth. The light takes 8 minutes and 20 seconds to reach the earth. So do you know what is the speed of the light? The speed of the light is 3 lakh kilometer per second. Light travels at the speed of 3 lakh kilometer per second, and it takes 8 minutes and 20 seconds to reach the earth from the sun. So this was about the sun. Now let's come to the planets. Next is planets. The word planet comes from the Greek word planetai, which means wanderers. Wanderers means those who keep on moving. Planetai means wanderer. Planets are wanderers. They keep on moving. As we all know, this is the sun. So all the planets, they move around the sun. That's why they are known as wanderers. Now, there are 8 planets. Number 1, Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and the last is Neptune. So these are the 8 planets in order of their distance from the sun. In order of their distance from the sun, the planets are Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus and Neptune. So to learn these planets in the order of their distance from the sun, you have to memorize a single sentence. My very efficient mother served us nuts. Means to say that Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars served us nuts. Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus and Neptune. So to learn all these planets in the order of their distance from the sun, you can memorize the single sentence, my very efficient mother just served us nuts. You can learn the planets in the order of their distance from the sun like this. Now let's come to the first planet, that is Mercury. Mercury is the nearest planet. This is Mercury. These parts are not known as orbits. What are orbits? The elongated path on which planets move around the sun, they are known as orbits. Here I am giving you an example. Like on sports day we have races. Okay, we have races on sports day. For different athletes, we draw different tracks. They run on their own track only. Number 1, 2, 3, 4. All the athletes, they run on their own track. Are they all complete the race at the same time? No. They take the different time to complete the races. Same as with the planets. So all the planets, they take different time to complete their revolution. First is Mercury. Mercury takes only 88 days to complete one circle. Only 88 days it takes to complete the round around the sun. It is the smallest planet and it is the nearest planet. This was about the Mercury. Next comes the Venus. It is very interesting planet. Venus. It is known as Earth's twin. Do you know what means twin? Twin means those who look identical or similar to each other. Because the size and the shape of the Venus is that of Earth, that's why it is known as Earth's twin. Second is, it is also the hottest planet. Hottest planet. Mercury, this is Venus. Why Venus is the hottest planet, not the Mercury? Mercury is closer to Sun, it should be the hottest planet, not the Venus. Here, it is because Mercury does not have atmosphere. It does not have that atmosphere that can trap and hold the heat. It receives the heat from the Sun, but that heat is quickly lost into the space. But therefore, Venus receives the heat of the Sun, trap the heat and hold the heat and make it to the hottest planet. That's why Venus is the hottest planet, not the Mercury. Then we come to the Earth. Earth, which is our unique planet. Why it is known as a unique planet? There are many reasons behind it. I am going to explain you. Earth. This is the third planet from the Sun. And have you ever seen the shape of the Earth? The shape of the Earth is not round, not spherical. It is slightly flattened at the poles. The shape of the Earth is like an orange. It is flattened at the poles and bulges in the middle. So, a shape of the Earth is described as geoid. Geoid means an Earth-like shape. Now, as the Mercury takes 88 days to complete one revolution, this Earth takes 365 days or 1 year to complete one revolution. Now, the unique planet, as I told you, Earth is a unique planet. There are many reasons behind this. We cannot live on any other planet. Why we cannot live on any other planet? We can live only on Earth. Because Earth has all the favorable conditions that we need for our survival. Number one is that it has water, without which we cannot live. We cannot live without water. So water is used to carry out day-to-day activities. So we cannot live without water, which is available on Earth. That's why it is a unique planet. Then comes the soil. Soil is present on the Earth. It is needed to grow crops, fruits and vegetables which we need for eating. So we cannot live without all these things. That's why soil is necessary. The very most important factor is that it has air. It has air which is very much essential for our survival. We cannot live without air. We can live without water. We can live without food for some time. But we cannot live without air for a moment. Okay? That's why air provides us all the life supporting gases like oxygen. So it is essential for our survival. Then the Earth has a ozone layer. ozone layer. So ozone layer protects us from the ultraviolet radiations, which can cause various skin diseases like skin cancer also. Then last but not the least, Earth is called a unique planet because it is neither too hot nor too cold. We can survive on it very comfortably. So all these points make the Earth a unique planet. Next thing is, Earth is also known as blue planet. Do you know why? Yes, you know it because we have studied it in last class, fifth class we have studied it. This is because the 71% of the surface of the Earth is covered with water. That's why it looks blue from the space and it is known as the blue planet. Now comes the Mars. Mars is known as the red planet. Do you know why? Mars is known as the red planet because it contains huge amount of iron oxide in it. Because it contains iron oxide. That's why it looks red in color. Then comes the Jupiter, Saturn and Uranus. These planets have rings around them, which can be seen from the Earth with the help of a powerful microscope. And Jupiter is also the largest planet. Smallest was Mercury. Smallest planet was Mercury. Largest is this. And hottest planet was Venus. And coldest planet is Neptune, because it does not receive the light of the sun properly. That's why it is the largest and coldest planet. Now, this was about the planets. Now, let's differentiate between the planets and stars. Planets and stars. Planets, they are countable. Planets, they are countable, they are aided number, and stars, they are uncountable. Stars are uncountable. Next, planets, they revolve around the sun, they are fixed at a point. They are smaller in size. They are larger than planets. Most important, they don't have their heat and light. Don't have heat and light. They have their own heat and light. They are countable, they are uncountable, they revolve around the sun, they are fixed at a point, they are smaller in size, they are larger than the planets, they don't have their own heat and light, and they have their heat and light. So this was about the planets, stars and sun. Now, the next one is the moon. Moon, this is the sun, Mercury, Venus, Earth. This is Earth. As the Earth revolves around the sun, Earth revolves around the sun in complete 1 year. It takes 1 year to complete the whole revolution. In the same way, Moon revolves around the Earth. And Moon takes 27 days to complete one revolution. Moon takes 27 days to complete one revolution. It is the natural satellite of the Earth. It appears so big to us because it is very near to us. It is the nearest star. Like it is 3,84,400 kilometers away from the earth. Now compare the distance of the sun. This is the distance of the moon from the earth. Distance of the sun from the earth is 150 million kilometers. So look at the distance of the sun and the moon. Sun is 150 million kilometers away from us and moon is 384,400 kilometers away. Have you ever wondered that why cannot we live on the moon? Because it does not have any favorable conditions for our survival. It has no air, no water, without which we cannot live. So we cannot live on the moon. Then comes the, have you ever seen moon in the same position? At the same position, moon has different positions. The shape of the moon is different at different times. These are known as the phases of the moon. Once in a month, we see full moon. Only once in a month we can see it. This is also known as Purnima. When we see the full moon. Then one night is such that there is no moon. And that night is known as new moon night. That night is known as new moon night or Amavasya. So we see full moon and fortnight later, after 15 days, 20 to 15 days, we see there is no moon in the sky, in the night sky, and that night is known as new moon night. And on that night, we can see the stars very bright in the sky because there is no moon in the sky. So that night is very clear and there are no clouds in the sky. Then comes the asteroids. Asteroids are the small rocky objects that move around the sun. They are smaller than the planets, that's why they are known as the minor planets. And we can see asteroid belt can be seen between the orbits of Mars and Jupiter. Like Sun, Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars and Jupiter. This is Jupiter, this is Mars. So here we can see in this belt, we can see asteroid belt. These are the rocky objects that move around the planets. Then comes the next term is meteoroids. Meteoroids are very tiny rocky particles. Very tiny rocky particles that move in the solar system. They are very tiny particles. When they come in the Earth's atmosphere with the friction of air, they burn and tend to drop on the Earth, what we call a shooting star. That is not a shooting star. And get in a tara root gaya. That is not tara root gaya. That is a shooting star. When a meteor and meteorites enter the Earth's atmosphere, when it burns with the friction of air, it produces a light that is known as shooting star. Now the galaxy. Next term is galaxy. Galaxy is a group of millions of stars. Millions or billions of stars together form a galaxy. Our solar system is a part of Milky Way galaxy. Milky Way galaxy. Milky Way galaxy, or it is also known as Akash Ganga. Akash Ganga. Milky Way galaxy or Akash Ganga. Our solar system is a part of Milky Way galaxy. So all the stars, they form the group of stars formed together, galaxy, that is known as our system is a part of Milky Way galaxy, and there are millions of such galaxies in the universe. Now to understand the point, this is you. You are the part of the Earth. Earth is the part of the solar system. The solar system is the part of the Milky Way galaxy. Milky Way galaxy, and Milky Way galaxy is the part of the universe. So there are many millions of galaxies, such galaxies in the universe. So what is universe now? Universe is that in which everything exists, from sun, moon, or planets, stars, everything that exists in the space that forms the universe. Now we are ending with the chapter, but before that I am going to tell you some interesting facts about the chapter. First is astronomers. Do you know who are astronomers? Astronomers. So astronomers are those who go in the space and they study the celestial bodies and their movement. They are known as astronomers. And one famous astronomer was Aryabhatta. One famous astronomer of ancient India was Aryabhatta. Then comes the first man. Do you know who was the first man to step on the surface of the moon? Yes, you should remember these names. Neil Armstrong. Neil Armstrong was the first man who stepped on the surface of the moon on 21st July 1969. Is there any Indian who has ever went to the moon? Yes. First Indian who went on the surface of the moon, that was Rakesh Sharma. Rakesh Sharma. So with this, I'm going to end the chapter. Hope to see you soon. Stay safe. Bye.